Good morning, everyone. Sweet Money here, and welcome back to another episode of Hack My Labor, the Starbase Tutorial Series, where we're kind of running out of things to do to our ship. I won't say this is the finale of Hack My Labor, since I might find a cool gadget I think would make a great fit, but I'm ready to move on to other things. There will be a short gap in content while I decompress, dig into new topics, and figure out exactly what I want to do going forward. This series involved a lot of time and effort on my part, but your reception to it and your comments really did keep it fun, and I don't think I would have gotten to an episode 16 without you all. So thank you for that. Keep the likes and comments and subs coming so we can have just as much fun in whatever videos come next. I've also loved seeing some of you stop by my Twitch channel. I'll still be streaming every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday, so stop by if you can. Anyways, today we're putting a few finishing touches on our labor module. We'll play with the lamps that were just added to the research tree and add some warnings for when your ship is broken. We'll tweak a couple YOLOL scripts to make our asteroid approach even better, and we'll write a new script that's purely optional, but I had a lot of fun working on, so I thought I'd share it with you. Let's get started with the new stuff. The most recent update as of this recording added a couple extra researches. The fun one we're gonna play with is lamps. These have only been available in the ship designer before this update. We're gonna do a couple of simple upgrades that will make use of lamps, so go ahead and unlock the research if you want, or just buy everything on the auction house. If you're gonna be crafting these lamps, you'll need a small amount of carnite and arcanium. I just bought a stack of each on the auction house. The first thing we're gonna wanna craft or buy is three fluorescent lamp A, 144 by 24 centimeters. This is a pre-assembled white lamp. We're gonna be using lamp A exclusively because I'm just adding a couple of lights inside my ship, and these things are bright. I'm hoping we get an intensity setting for them in the future. If you're looking to add lights outside your ship, you might want to look into lamp B and C, as they're even brighter. One area of our labor that I feel gets the darkest is the back of the ship, so let's use our new lamps to light it up back there. Since these lights are so bright, I'm going to tuck them back by our cargo crate so it's not so easy to stare directly at them. Place one lamp on the ceiling at the end of each row of cargo crates. Auto bolt them down and we can run some cable. I'm going to run a cable from this lamp through the spare fuel rod rack and connect it to the other lamp. Now I'll run one more cable to this duct in the opening. And oh my god, that's bright. If you can still see anything, do the same thing on the other side to wire up the last lamp. If you open your universal tool in data mode with the U key, you'll see we have a single field called lamp on. Set this to zero to turn off the lamp. Obviously, we don't want to be using our universal tool on each lamp whenever we want to turn the lights on and off, so let's make a new control table stand 45 and hybrid button. Since the lights are in the back, just mount your control table next to your side door buttons and bolt your hybrid button to it. Wire this up and you can rename the button state field to lamp on and change the button style value to 1. Now we can just press the button and all the lights turn on and off. For our next trick, we're going to need a few things. Craft or buy two lamp A base 144 by 24 centimeter and two bulb A red R10 500LM. If you want anything other than a white lamp, you'll need to craft or buy the base separately from the bulb. Let's install these up front. This little hallway behind our chair feels like a good spot, so remove this top decorative wall piece and line the lamp A base up against the beam on each side. Auto bolt these down and you should be able to just snap the red bulb into the lamp base. Now you can run some cable to the lamp base to the ducts in the wall here and replace the wall piece you removed. We're going to rename the lamp on field for both of these lamps to be ship bad light, and I'll just set the value to 0 to turn the light off. Next, we're going to craft or buy a ship diagnostic scanner and an audio signal device Mark 1. You can mount these devices wherever you want, but I found the spot right behind the flight control unit to be pretty good for the diagnostic scanner. Bolt it down and connect it to power with a cable. Use the universal tool to set the active field's value to 1 to turn the scanner on. Then rename the durability errors field to ship bad. This scanner will monitor your ship's strength factor as well as report how many durability errors it finds. Now we can install our audio signal device on the ceiling above. You know the drill by now. Bolt it down and connect it to power with a cable. Now open up your universal tool on the speaker and you'll find a plethora of fields. We're only going to worry about a couple of these for right now because we're going to be controlling our alarm and lights with YOLOL. Let's rename sound on to ship bad sound. Setting this to 1 will play a sound once and then set itself back to 0. This is technically all we need to do, but I'm going to change my sound category to 5 because it's a literal cat meow and I can't get enough of my ship meowing at me whenever it's sad. And then we'll set our radius to 2. 200 because that's the maximum so we can hear it from as far away as possible. Now let's write a really simple YOLOL script to make this all work. If you're out of room in your YOLOL sockets, just move a chip to the racks. Now line 1 is just checking if ship bad is anything other than 0. Ship bad represents the durability errors field from our diagnostic scanner, so if it's not 0, then we have at least one durability error somewhere, and we move to line 2. This line just sets our ship bad light and ship bad sound to 1, which will turn them both on. We skip a bunch of lines to pass some time, and then turn off the ship bad light for a moment before moving back to line 1 and repeating the whole process. The easiest way to test this out is to remove a bolt or two from a plate. This plate only has a single bolt in it now, so our ship should have a durability error. Sure enough, we can see the lights flashing and hear a very satisfying meow sound until the durability error is resolved. Put a bolt back in this plate and the alarm turns off. Super cool! Alright, next we have just a few really quick tweaks that will help with our asteroid approach system. First thing came from the comments, and it's a no-brainer. This battery 2 screen is pretty useless right now, so let's rename it to APD. You can delete the max battery power field name so it gets reset back to its default panel max value, and then set its value to 1000. I like the extra precision, so I also set my panel variable resolution to 0.001. The screen is going to be especially useful when lining up an asteroid that's far away. You'll know you hit the asteroid when the meter moves away from 1000. Next, we're going to be tweaking our turtle script and our asteroid approach script a tiny bit. In our turtle mode script, we're simply going to start setting our FCU general multiplier to be 15% when turtle mode is on, instead of just modifying our forward thruster control. The extra maneuver thrusters we added make it a lot harder to make tiny changes when turning our ship. Setting the FCU general multiplier will limit all of our thrusters instead of just our forward thrust. This is incredibly useful when trying to line up your approach laser with a tiny asteroid in the distance. Next up, let's tweak our approach script just a tiny bit. I'm going to change T to 60, TM to 1, MX to 10, MN to 15, and BT to 60. I found these values worked really well for me. I didn't have a lot of bouncing back and forth, and the ship seemed to stop in a really good mining laser range. You might still have to tweak some things if your ship's weight varies a little bit, but these have been working pretty good for me. Alright, we're almost done! This script is completely optional, but I wanted to share it with you because I had some fun figuring it out and writing it. Currently, we're adding all of our fuel rods together and displaying it on a screen up front. But what if one of our fuel rods dies before the rest of them? I wanted to have a way of displaying all my fuel status on a single text panel, and I wanted it to be more fun than a bunch of percentages on a screen, so I made some makeshift progress bars. You'll need a text panel and another YOLO chip for this. Remove the fuel rods and propellant screens and place the text panel in that space. Rename the text panel to fuel status. Now install another YOLO chip in the back and let's get this script started. Lines 11 through 20 are where we define the progress bar text. Bar is set to a string that's 9 characters long, which will fit perfectly on a single line of our text panel when we add the brackets later on. Z is a state variable that just says that we set the bar string. Then we go to line I plus L, which will make more sense in a second. On line 1 we define a few things. N is just a new line string. RM is the maximum fuel in a rod. PM is our total propellant for our ship. L just defines the line number of code our first text panel line gets processed. And I is the index of the text panel line we're currently working on. On line 2, we define the rods and propellant as shorter variables to save space. Line 3 is where we set the text panel to equal all of our processed text panel lines. We set Z to 0, and we go to whichever line of code is L plus our current index. Now lines 4 through 9 all do the same thing, just for a different line of our text panel. They check if Z is 0. If it is, they go to line 11 plus the percentage of that fuel times 10. For example, if we have 80% of our fuel left, we get 0.8 times 10, so we'll go to line 11 plus 8, or 19. Line 19 will then set bar to equal the progress bar text, Z equal to 1, and then go back to whichever line it came from. When that line gets executed again, Z is no longer 0, so it sets the string for that line of the text panel to the bar text plus some brackets around it and new line. It sets Z back to 0 again, increments our index, and then goes back to line 2 so it could do it all over again for the next fuel source. The only thing that's different is line 9, where we set the index back to 0, and then we go back to the top of the script. Hopefully some of that made sense to you. I'm sure there's a cool algorithm that can do this even better, or you can use a bunch of YOLO chips and a memory chip to do things a little faster, but I think this works well for what I was looking to do. If we go to the front of our ship now, we can see 6 progress bar lines which represent each of our fuel rods and our propellant. And that's a wrap for now. I think we did a lot of great things for our labor, and I can't wait to bring you all more tutorials about different aspects of Starbase. I really do appreciate all of you watching and all of your kind words. One last time, if you enjoyed this video, please do leave me a like and consider subscribing so you'll be the first to know about new videos when they release. If you want to hang out with me live on Twitch, I stream every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you in the next one. But for now, please take it easy.